Hi everybody, Martin here, and today I'm implementing the new spring tension mechanism for the Marble Machine X. The new spring tension mechanism is a small part of a major redesign of some of the core functions of the Marble Machine X. I introduced this redesign back in episode 136, and I walked through the reasons for this redesign in depth in there. So I won't go into it as much here. Before assembling new parts, I need to remove a whole bunch of obsolete parts that are no longer needed. This is going to be a quite brutal disassembly. I think it took me around 2 hours to remove parts that I've been working with on and off for at least 2 years. And while I love starting over and improving things, this major redesign was nothing I actually wanted to do, but the functionality of the machine needed it, so I really had no choice. Here you can see the old spring placement and tensioning system. The three major flaws with this design was that number one, the springs are in the way of my new design. Number two, the springs are causing friction by sliding on the rods they are surrounding. And number three, in this old system, I could adjust the spring tension for all the channels by sliding an iron bar back and forth and locking it down. But in the new system, I will be able to adjust the spring tension individually for all the 38 channels. And this is quite a big deal for the Marble Machine X. You might think that removing 2 years of your life is an agonizing experience, but I'm actually enjoying myself here. I've already done all the hard work of making the decision to actually do the redesign, and now we can have fun assembling. And I'm especially happy to get rid of this particular plywood part. This is an afterthought, and it has caused problems throughout. And my new design renders this part completely obsolete, so bye bye, I won't cry. All these PMMA pipes are removed for the 100th time, and here I'm removing the underside of the marble divider. The absolute last thing I needed to remove is this lid on the left side of the frame of the marble machine, and the problem is that I have broken off a hex key inside this bolt, so I can't access the bolt to actually unscrew it. And I'm aware of some methods that you can use in these situations. You can drill out the whole screw. You can use a puncher to kind of try to circulate the screw by punching it around. But in this case, I want to try the Dremel. So I'm just cutting with a cutting disc a groove, and then I'm using a normal screwdriver to unscrew the screw. Super quick, effortless, and fast. And with this last lid removed from the machine, we can now take a look on what I've actually discarded and removed from the machine. And it's a quite frightening collection of beautiful parts lying here on my work table. Not all of these parts will be completely removed. I'm going to recycle a few pieces. For example, this marble divider here, I'm recycling this top section, but everything else goes. From the beginning of building the Marble Machine X, I have actually saved each and every part that I've taken off the machine. This has resulted in this huge plastic box filled with discarded parts. It's quite scary to look at it, but it's really cool. It doesn't look so big on video, but in real life it's actually monstrous. Here's Wilson for some perspective for you. All these parts is really a trip down memory lane of the Marble Machine X, and I think sometimes in the future I will make something useful from them. I'm thinking that I can turn them into some kind of sculptures and give them out to the longest supporting patrons and YouTube members as a really unique way of saying thank you for supporting this project. I think these pieces are kind of poetic as a kind of a building blocks of the dream of the Marble Machine X. I will keep collecting all the discarded pieces. I will need to start a second plastic box really soon. Okay, we're ready to start assembly. I'm marking the position of this bar because it's not entirely symmetrical, so I need to keep the direction correct for everything to line up in the end. And then I want to clean these mild steel laser cut pieces from the mill scale to do some tack welds. So a huge shout out here to Doug Kirby from the Westlake Ace hardware store in Mountain View, California. Doug sent me this crazy gift of Dremel consumables. This will definitely take me through the finishing of the Marble Machine X. So thanks a lot, Doug. I wanted to see if I could clean this mild steel up with the Dremel just to be lazy so I didn't have to walk downstairs to my angle grinder. But the Dremel was a little bit too slow. It's not really the correct job for the Dremel, so in the end I used the angle grinder instead. The 38 springs combined will create quite a lot of pressure on this bar, so I designed it in a kind of an I-bar shape with these side pieces strengthening this whole bar. And with the welds done, I could then move on to start on the side pieces. If you remember in the beginning of the build, I was always breaking taps, and it's because these pieces are laser cut. In the beginning I didn't respect it, so I laser cut the holes to the dimension and then tapped the laser cut holes, and a lot of taps were broken. Now I'm instead designing the holes smaller, and then I'm just enlarging them on the drill press to get rid of all the heat hardened metal. And then I use a countersink to chamfer both sides of the metal, and then a lot of oil, and then tapping is no problem. I haven't broken a tap for 2 years, I think. So that was really just a learning curve in the beginning. At this moment, I thought I was finished downstairs, but then I realized, hey, I have to put all the tools back. I'm trying to teach myself to put all my tools back after each finished procedure. I made a video about this a while ago, so while I'm building the spring tension system here, I'm also practicing keeping clean around me. So far it goes okay. Now we come to the part of this design that I actually think is pretty elegant, simple, and functional. These two top strips of metal will retain the nut from rotating. This makes for very, very simple and secure spring tensioning adjustment. These two side pieces will actually become a part of the frame of the Marble Machine X. I need this bolt connection because the two side frames are not meant to be welded together at any spot. I need to keep the two side frames removable. I've designed this to be positioned in the corner of the frame, so I know exactly where to weld it on. My CAD dimension seems to work out perfectly, the bar fitted perfectly into the frame of the Marble Machine X. So now I can move on to the spring tension mechanism itself. So from these parts, I'm going to reuse the springs and the plywood section. And while I'm removing all the springs, I just wanted to make an announcement regarding mid-roll ads. YouTube rolled out a big push 3 months ago that automatically enabled mid-roll ads on all the YouTube videos available, kind of. I don't know about you, but I've experienced watching YouTube has become much worse since this mid-roll ad push. So I am deliberately not using mid-roll ads in the Wintergatan videos for the moment. And I want to thank all the Wintergatan patrons and YouTube members for making me feel that I don't have to push the ad monetization as hard as I can for these videos, because I think mid-roll ads is really destroying the viewing experience. A big downside of my decision to not use mid-roll ads is that YouTube itself has less incentive to recommend Wintergatan videos to the public. YouTube is of course incentivized to recommend videos with more ads, which makes them more money, but the really sad thing here is that I think creators are being pushed into enabling mid-roll ads because we want our content to be seen. So I think there's a lot of creators who don't want this algorithmic disadvantage with not having mid-roll ads. If I would ever enable mid-roll ads, it would be not to make more money, but to actually reach out with my videos to the audience. Probably the advertisers are asking for this. I just think this is a good example of where ad-based business models leads to less quality in human interaction. Yeah. Okay, end of rant from Mr. Head in the Utopia Clouds himself. I used to be so proud of being part of Team YouTube that we were killing off annoying mainstream TV. Now my own team is becoming annoying mainstream TV. So yeah. Anyway, something that is the opposite of annoying though is these amazing custom-made M5 rods made by Henk Reichardt from Cotterai.be. And what's amazing with these rods is that I asked for the rods like on a Tuesday and they arrived to my house on like a Friday or something. So huge shout out to Henk, thank you so much. So So here I'm really happy to see that everything is lining up like I hoped it would in CAD. And here you can see that the spring is pretty loose. And with only one hand, I can actually tighten the spring very, very fast. Here's from the other direction. I just have to pull the spring out, get the nut loose, adjust it to any tension I want, and drop the nut back in its slot again. I can't actually think of a simpler, fewer parts design for a spring tensioning system. In the back here for the registrators, I'm using the exact same principle. I can just pull a threaded rod out, adjust the position of the nut, and drop it back again. The spring can't rotate, the nut can't rotate, nothing can really shift as long as there's tension on the spring. So far, so good, but this is only a very small first step in this major redesign. This redesign is not about the spring tension is a small part of everything that will change. And I will continue with this redesign in the next chapter of the Marble Machine X build. And at this moment in time, it's like painfully obvious to me that this is not a music instrument anymore. This machine is a meditation over my own mental ability or lack thereof. It's a crazy journey sailing these oceans of doubt and wondering if this whole project is sunken cost fallacy. I want to finish this episode off with two quotes that I heard from Stephen Fry in a recent Origins podcast. On the topic of doubt and darker sides of the creative process, Stephen quoted someone that said, "Don't take away my demons or my angels will fly away too." And on the topic of the real fear of actually potentially failing with this whole machine, and I stopped dead in my tracks when I heard Stephen reading out this quote from Robert Browning. I'm going to let this quote end this episode, but it will also mark the beginning of the last chapter in the Marble Machine X building saga. The upcoming months is a real make it or break it moment for the Marble Machine X, and I'm inviting you all to take part in this engineering drama as it plays out. Okay, so back to this 200-year-old Robert Browning quote. It goes, "A man's reach should exceed his grasp, or what's a heaven for?"